I had an exhibition in Florence. The mayor of Florence wanted me to be present at that opening. I was not able to be present, and so he said, okay, we don't do the show. And so me, I said, look, I will tell that I am dead. And so I said, I am dead. And the television, someone, Italian television, said, Pesce died, so I was dead. In my life, I did strong moments in creativity, and then I disappear. And then I reappear with other things, and then I disappear, I reappear. Why? Because I have a problem. If I talk too much, I risk to repeat. I am called Gaetano Pesce. I am 82 years since Monday. Originally from Venice, on the side of my mother, and on the side of my father, I am from Florence. In a school in Venice, I learned a lot about color, because the Venetian art is done with light and color. And then from Tuscany, I understood the importance of the drawing with no color. This is more or less my identity. I am curious, and I keep giving nutrition to this curiosity. Until today, architecture is a kind of artistic expression, which is very coherent. Nothing to say except the beautiful shape. To do architecture, it's very difficult, for new idea, because they say, we would like you to design something that I saw last week in, I don't know where, Bahamas. I say, look what Bahamas has to do with here. But my building were one in Osaka, which is an innovation that a lot of people copied. Like in the facade of an office building, I create a kind of garden. Then people understood that we can create green on the facade of the building. Then I create a little house in a foam in south of Italy. Then I create a house in Brazil, in an area where the identity of the people is music, color, talking, singing. And so I did a kind of architecture who was very happy. What I really like about the past project was this tower where each floor is different. Different not by the same architect, but different architect who together create a kind of statement on architecture. I did this in 1968, and it's a symbol of, why is important this? Because it's a symbol who allowed us to go on. It's very big with the foot to go back. So it's a symbol of advancing, going, crossing. So this is a tribute to that part of the body who allowed us to go on. Yes, they called the mama. But the title Act 5 and 6 was because it was done with a kind of foam, and it was this high. And when he was opening the envelope, his chair was coming up. And it was a miracle, like, wow. That was good for storage. Instead of store 20 chairs, it was storing in the same space 100. Traveling or shipping the chair was very easy, no, because it was in this a disc. In the meantime, so the world was very interested to this technological aspect. But in reality, the important aspect of the chair was that the chair had an ottoman, that it was a sphere, and it was connected with a chain. That was the representation of the, you know, in the old time, the prisoner, they had this ball, and is this image of non-freedom. And this was the condition of the woman in a lot of, for a lot of long time, for centuries, and until today, because in a lot of countries, women suffer for non-freedom. And it's a great mistake. And that chair was a tribute to this kind of problem. There is a God, which is time. And time, in a way or in another, decides everything we do. From the moment we come up in life to the moment where we die, is a decision of time. Time is the one who created these values. And we are, our job, or my job, is understand what the time is telling today and try to express it. So if I look this chair, this was a chair that I made 37 years ago. And at that time, I did this idea to have 9 chairs with the same shape. But the formula of the resin was changing. So number one was done with the resin that when I was taking out the chair from the mold, the chair was collapsing. And that was the image of a human body with no bones. And that chair was not anymore a chair, but it was a sculpture, because it was this kind of a strange on the floor. Then the second one, number two, was a chair, was like a jelly. It was touching and then it was moving in a certain way, standing up, but maybe not. And the third was standing up, but it was not able to allow the child to sit, because in that case it was collapsing. And then the number four was good for a child. It was sitting, but not for the adult, because the adult was collapsing. And then the number six, et cetera, et cetera. It was allowing people to sit until 8 and 9, that it was so rigid that it was difficult to sit, because it was. So just to say that depending of the chemical formula, an object is an art, or is not, or is a design, or is a sculpture, or is a chair. And that was interesting because it was representing a moment where we don't know what is art and what is non-art, or what is design, depending on a formula. Imagine, it's not depending on our, but depending on a chemical formula. So that was what I said, 36 years ago. There was a woman exceptional in dance called Pina Bausch. It was exceptional because she invented a way to dance, but not dance as a kind of formal repetition of the old way to dance on the feet, etc. She invented a performance in a certain way. It's a tribute to her. Not only the movement of the body, but there was painting, there was sculpture, there was everything that is composing art. Looking to my work without knowing who did that, etc., I believe that someone that is like a fish going, etc., going there, coming back and going back again and discovering and being happy, etc. And also I see that is a work that is positive, is optimistic. We want something better. We want something more good. We want something more alive. We want something liquid. Liquidity allowed you to be free. Now you think this now, tomorrow you think different. You go up and down like water. Our time is a liquid time. Values disappear. Last year we were thinking something. This year we think different. Maybe tomorrow different. This is the beauty of our time. The static life is horrible. It's like dying before time. I am Gaetano Pesce, and I have a great question. I am the most interesting designer in the world. But it's not me to answer, it's you.